Hey, and don't be lipping off anymore. Be lipping off to your mama.
That was not my mama.
Uh-huh. Stay to the left as far as you can, like up against that rock wall. To the left. You're turning to the right. I want you to the left. Well, what's up, guys? It's Daniel from Arms Family Homestead, and I come to a conclusion. I think I've realized something. You know, these spring days are beautiful, and the days get longer and longer through the spring. Winter months, they're real short days, long nights. It's like God had a plan. It's like he knew when it was cold, we were just going to sit in the house and hide from the cold. But as the days get longer, the chore lists get longer, and you got so much more to do. Well, that's the case right now. Weston's here. He's off in the pasture picking up a bunch of limbs and sticks so that our hay fields don't have limbs laying in them. And then when he gets finished with that, I'm going to have him load up the four-wheeler and my little drag harrow, take it over to the merchandise property because we had that bulldozer in there doing all that work and kind of tore up the ground everywhere. I'm going to see if he can kind of smooth out the ground with just a drag harrow. If not, we'll end up having to take a tractor and a landscape rake over there and kind of just smooth it out so that we can actually mow the grass before the grass grows. Eventually, it's going to grow up and be, you know, hard to mow if we don't. But I'm going to do a few chores here, and then later this afternoon, I think we're going to load up. Well, you can't see it. It's like perfectly hidden. The 574 and put a brush hog on it, take it over to Weston's house at the Mill Creek property so I can let him do some work over there. But I got to check on all the animals, do all the chores here, see how everybody's doing. Jesse. Hey. Jesse. Wake up. I see you. Jesse. You ignoring me this morning? And speaking of extra chores, had a friend call this morning that's wanting one of these buck kids, so I sent him a video. I'm not sure which one they're going to take, but there are four buck kids, and the other three, whichever three that may be, are going to be leaving tomorrow as well. Jesse, are you okay this morning? Were you napping good? Did I wake you up? Did I wake you up this morning? And I could be wrong, but if I had to guess, I'm going to say this is probably the one they'll take. Little Dapple. Hey, Jesse, don't bite me. Jesse, what are you doing? What are you doing? Do you need attention today? You just need some loving. How's Mr. RJ? Well, Bear's doing good. Bear needs attention. Everybody is needing all kinds of attention today. Hang on. I'm going to squat down and see if RJ will come over here to us. Come on, RJ. Bear, you're scaring RJ. He's not real sure what you're doing. RJ. Hey, come here, buddy. Come here, RJ. Bear. I think you're too intimidating for RJ. Why are you so noisy? All right, RJ, Bear ran off. He ran off. Hey, come here, buddy. What are you doing? You're such a skinny little guy. You know that? What are you doing? Where'd you go? There you are. What are you doing, RJ? You're just like Jesse. Hey, what are you doing? Quit going around behind me. That's not going to cut it. You're not going to be allowed to do that. I know you think you're big and tough, but you're not. You're a little guy. You're still a little shrimpy little fellow, but we can't have you jumping on people. Oh, my goodness. You're pushy. You are Rufus Jr. You know that? You may not have ever met Rufus. You may not have met your dad. But you're just him reincarnated, I think. Uh-uh. You're not jumping on me. There's Phoebe. How's Phoebe this morning? Hmm? Are you doing all right? Huh? And Fallon. And here comes Farrah. Yep, everybody's doing good this morning. All the rest of the little donkey poodles are chilling and hanging out, looking good after their haircuts. Our old lady there, she's not in the greatest condition, but pulling RJ off of her, she should put some weight back on fairly quickly. So things are kind of greening up, but I do need to get this pasture reseeded. You know, we got the wood seeder a while back, and I haven't had a chance to get it hooked up to the tractor yet and test it out. Oh, Ralph, you need some fly spray on your face. I need to get some fly spray after you. Horse flies are on your nose, buddy. You know that? Well, let's get some chores done this morning. Bring Houston Tortoise outside. Let him get a little sunshine during the days. During the daylight, it's still too cool at night for him, so. Brought you a tomato there, buddy. Cut it up for you. We bring him outside and let him get some sunlight on these warm days like this, but still cool at night. So we'll give him a tomato, pull him some grass, and he'll be happy for the day. Copper, are you sleeping good, buddy? What is the deal today? The weather just got everybody tired? You were snoozing, man. Weren't you? The dirty birds today. Turkey. Turkey lurkey. Don't go back there. Watch out. Aren't you? Just loud mouthy noisy geese. That's what you're gonna be. For real, Ralph. Your face is under attack. Are you gonna let me put fly spray on your face? Cause we gotta do it, buddy. We gotta get something on your face. Look out. Look out, look out. Fresh water coming in. Hey, sometimes guys, you all see this water situation and think we're making the donkey and the babies drink dirty water. All that is a distraction for the ducks. I can give fresh water in this, and the ducks, you know, I'll just put some water in there. The ducks like that dirty water, but I'll put a little bit of water in there. The duck get in there and play. And then their water stays clean. We have a special guest on today's episode. Good morning. All I can hear is the water. Hang on. Anyways, so Jessie always does get clean water. Don't think she drinks that stuff. You see how lazy those two little goats are? They're just laying there eating. Water's full. It's Ralph's got those horse flies all over his face, and there's no way he's gonna let me spray his face. So I'm gonna use a little wiping spray. It's actually for horses, but it'll keep the flies off of his face, and I'll spray the rest of his body in a little bit. The rest of the alpacas and stuff, I don't see the horse flies attacking them. There's none on the donkeys, but it wouldn't hurt to, well, I see a few around their face, but it wouldn't hurt to go ahead and spray them down with a little bit of fly spray, just because since we sheared them off, now all their skin's exposed and the flies are really able to actually bite them, where before, you know, most of their body's covered in fleece and they don't get bit. So I'm gonna wipe a little bit of this on Ralph's face real quick.
Phoebe, stop.
All right. Smells like those citronella candles, like when you go camping, those green, you know, cans that you burn for mosquitoes.
Mm-hmm.
What this stuff smells like. Citronella. Ralph, come here. Come here. You're always pushy.
He's on to you.
Have to get a bucket of feed. He'll come to the feed bucket. Anybody else want some?
Might as well rub a little on your face around your eyes so you don't get flies around your eyes, huh? You want some too, Fallon?
Oops.
Oh, she's trying to wipe it off. You're like, what in the world you put on me? Oh, I smell like citronella.
I bet she knew that word.
Yep, she did. Oh.
Farrah wanted in on it.
A little too. Ralph. Well, I didn't get much on him, but I don't see any horse flies on his face.
No. He said, no thanks. Girls. A little trickery here. There's the two pregnant girls right there.
Old Ralph. We had him watching.
Mm-hmm.
What's up, buddy?
Yeah,
breakfast. Hey, Ralph, I'm not doing anything suspicious here.
He said, no thanks.
Not gonna work. But he's in a funky mood today.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Ralphie, I've got a treat for you. Be still, Pepper. You need some too, Lucy? I mean, Reba. Not Lucy. We'll let Ralph get up there and eat. And we'll do a little sneak attack. Got you, Ralph. No flies on you now. RJ, you want some too? You don't even know. I see a horse fly on you. Ooh. Hang on, buddy. Why are you kicking at me? It'll keep the flies off of you, make you feel better. Trust me. That'll do. Tilt it forward. Tilt it forward. There you go. See if he can line up and get the bucket. I know. Hang on. Tilt it forward just a little bit. Push it away from you. Now come forward and lift up a little. There you go. Now roll it to you. Congratulations, you did it. I know, it's really hard to see. Hang on. All right, now back up to the brush hog over there. Hey, and don't be lipping off anymore. Be lipping off to your mama.
That was not my mama.
Uh-huh. Hey, we can't tell them it was me, right?
No.
No, you did that to yourself.
That's nice.
Hang on. Get ready for this up.
So I figure if I'm going to send him and the tractor with an implement to do work, I'm going to take him over there, give him a little refresher on everything, show him how everything works. I'm going to do a little bit of mowing probably, but I'm going to send the brush hog instead of the flail mower because it's a much less expensive implement to learn and make a couple mistakes on. Jerry, you got anything to say today? Nothing? Just nibbling my green grass off. Get the trailer hooked up. Load a tractor. Let him learn a few things. Probably make him tow the tractor over there. Jeez, guys. Laying down on the job again, huh? It's like hanging out with Weston. Perfect. Put the pin in. It's over there. And then pull her down there in the driveway and we'll load the tractor. Alright. This is me trying to let go of a little bit of control and teach and instruct, and I struggle with that. I know that's one of my shortcomings, but he's got to learn. He's 20. So, get him driving the tractor up on the trailer. Help him, teach him how to load it down. Raise your bucket a little bit. That way you can see. I need like some wireless communication to talk to him. Pull forward a little bit. But hey, as you pull forward, you got to remember you got a brush hog that might hit those fenders. You got to look all the way around you. So you can pull forward, you've got room, but just make sure you don't tear off my fenders. That makes sense? It's a lot. He's thinking really hard.
All right, roll your bucket forward. Lay it down. Roll it. Roll it. Okay, let your brush hog down.
He's gonna slam it down, you watch.
Ooh, nope. Good job, good job. All right. Killer.
Good work.
My head hurts.
It's a little intimidating, isn't it?
Just because you can't see anything.
I know. Now we got to load it down, or strap it down, I mean. I'm glad you remembered that. Good work. It's hard to do everything one-handed.
Not sure which way that feels.
can't get this all the way back over. It's going to hook into the chain twice.
All right, Wes. You know what every man is obligated to say when they strap something down on a trailer? You slap it. You go, she ain't going nowhere. You have to say that or it will fall off. I'm not used to this whole passenger seat thing in my own truck. It's really weird. Feels like I'm trying to eat with the wrong hand or something. So we're going to have Weston's first lesson at pulling a big heavy load up the hill out of the creek. It's tricky. Stay to the left as far as you can, like up against that rock wall. To the left, you're turning to the right. I want you to the left. Yeah, you were. You gotta be always close to that side as you can. If not, you get on that rock ledge right there. There you go. You got it. You got it. You got it. The steering wheel was turning to the right as I'm saying go left.
Wasn't it?
Oh, it wasn't?
No.
Okay. Well, you made it to the top. Earl, we survived, buddy. We survived. It's a good song right there. Good song, good song. Someone asked me the other day how many windmills were out here near our Mill Creek property. And I don't have an answer for you, but whoop, bugs. But there's a bunch. I bet there's, I don't know, probably 75 or 80 windmills out here. I mean, you think from here north towards town.
A few more than that.
Might be 100. Might be 100.
Just quite a bit.
I just pull up there in the shade and then we'll back the trailer in. I don't know. Figure out how. I just pull up there in the shade though.
I guess we can just leave it here.
You can do it. It's not going to dump you.
Never backed
one off the trailer. I've only ever pulled up. Yeah. There you go. Back her off. Earl, he did it, buddy. He did it. He did it. It didn't crunch anything. Don't fall in. Anything down there? Make a wish. All right. Let's go. Time to learn. Earl, stay out of the way. Come here. Went over everything. Yeah, just start mowing those roads out, dude. So, kind of went over a tutorial with him. He's gonna, there you go, PTO shafts on, idle it up. He's gonna take off and I'm gonna get out of the way. Earl, you stay out of the way too, buddy. I am going to swing this gate the other way. I just noticed they drove a big metal rod in the ground. I don't want him to hit that. And there's a lot of a lot of stuff he can do over here without my help once we get him. I'm going to stay with him today for a couple hours or so and let him learn everything on that. But all of this needs to be brush hogged down. It's all still small enough that that Homestead implements, brush hog, rotary cutter, whatever you want to call it, can take all this stuff out and he can clean up around these trees. Look, I mean, that's a big, beautiful oak tree. And this little area will be a really pretty field, but if we don't take care of it now, within a couple of years, this will all just be overgrown and cedars will take over and the brush will take over. So get it nice and cleaned up.
See his first obstacle. There's a dead cedar tree.
He just went right over the top of it. Not a problem though. I'm gonna get out of the way so I don't get stuff thrown in my face. Not seem like a big thing to a lot of people, and I know a lot of old timers say they were on a tractor running a brush hog when they were 10 years old, but farming has never really been Weston's thing. I'm not gonna lie, he was into sports and girls and all the things, and you know, running a tractor is just not real high on his priority list as he was younger. And being able to hire him, and now actually him have a place to live right here on this property, and he can come out here and work for a couple hours here, come to the house, work for a couple hours, do, you know, orders, help us do orders and all that stuff. But this right here, guys, is a tremendous time saver, tremendous asset for me to be able to have him. Like, having this extra 80 acres, it's a little bit, I'm not gonna lie, it's a little bit of extra stress, because I want it to look good. I want it to be taken care of. I want to, you know, clean it up. And I can't be over here 8 hours a day all the time. And we've just got so many other things going on. But being able to hire Weston and for him to be able to come over here and do this and take care of the equipment. I want to teach him to take care of the equipment, teach him to maintain it, teach him to do things the right way. Because that is a lot of money sitting there, you know. I mean, that's a one-year-old, one-and-a-half-year-old, 55-horsepower cab tractor. My dad taught me on a mid-80s long, which was kind of like an old Ford open cab tractor with a 4-foot brush hog. You know, if something would have happened, it wasn't near as big of a expensive tractor. It's a lot of money, a lot of responsibility right there, so I hope he takes it serious. Yeah, all of this stuff needs to be cut down, knocked down, cut back. That rotary cutter on the tractor will handle it. It's going to take him some time, but he can come over here, you know, days we don't have anything going on at the house, and work for a couple hours and do his own thing on his own schedule. Looking good. Man, so much prettier after you knock.
Hey, raise your bucket. I'm gonna have to stop him. He's got the bucket down on the ground almost. He's gonna run into the dirt.
Ducks on the pond. Kind of hard to see. They're hiding under that tree.
I won't disturb you.
Guys, check this out. I know it may not look like much right now, and it's only about maybe 1 acre, 1.5 acre, something that he's brush hogged and mowed down, but it looks so much better. I mean, let's walk to the edge and look at the difference. There's all kinds of, you know, grasses and clovers coming up in this. It's gonna be really pretty. Gonna have some, you know, we can come in here and plant a lot of this in deer plots and stuff. Not that we're planning on bringing animals over here to graze. The fences are not for that. They're not in near good enough shape for that. But there's what it looks like before. And I don't know if it comes across that well on video. But look at the line. Look at the difference. Nice, pretty green pasture and overgrown brush. So I figure over the next month, maybe 2 months even, I'm not in a rush. But all the open areas need to be mowed and clean, knock down all the brush, knock down all the cedar trees, probably bring the skid steer over here, do some work with it. I know my brother-in-law Dusty's got that tree puller that I helped him get, the same company that sent my grapple. And, you know, anyways, guys, so much work to do, but having Weston here full-time, living here, he can do it a little at a time. This place is gonna look so much different in a few months. And the mosquitoes are thick. Oh, got him. Anyways, I'm excited about it. I'm pumped. I'm almost a little bit emotional, like, at how much different this looks than that right there. It's awesome. I'm excited. He's gonna be over here working. But anyways, guys, that's all I've got for today. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. You guys have a great day. And as always, we'll see you on the next video.